was vice president of a hospital in Indiana. Everything was falling apart. And in order to deaden those feelings of being unsuccessful, I drank. And the more I drank, the more unsuccessful I became. It was a revolving door.
John came home one evening when he was living with my mother, and I was there and she was there, and he had driven her car while under the influence of alcohol. It had a flat tire. We heard it come in the driveway, and I knew that something was terribly wrong. Before the police got there, he and I had a physical encounter. And the police did come, he was arrested, and from that point was when I got the order of protection.
I had alienated all of my family members.
The jail time involved of being arrested, you know, loss of home, loss of belongings.
It was shambles.
Many of us were not aware anymore of what was actually going on at the point when he reached out to AA and lived at Theodoro Place. The residence of Wellspring at Theodoro Place was evidently the greatest starting point for him.
What Wellspring did for me was they gave me an incentive to get up in the morning.
The counselors, the doctors, all of the staff at Wellspring were the ones who really helped him get back on his feet.
They had classes. They encouraged me to attend AA. They turned my life around. Had it not been for them, I would not have had the confidence to meet this head on. I have pancreatic cancer, and without the self-confidence that they've reestablished in me, I would not have been able to meet this disease head on.
I was concerned about how he would handle the news that he has pancreatic cancer.
They established a certain spirit in me, along with the self-confidence, that I really feel confident I can make this.
We're kind of taking it day by day because we're not sure how the illness is progressing.
It was obvious to me that the resources and support that he gets from Wellspring had such a great impact on how he handled this.
It's not a job. It's a pleasure to do what I do, and I'm grateful to do it. I'm just grateful that I had the gift given to me and now I can pass it on to others.
They are so dedicated. And they save lives. You know, emergency room doctors save lives, but so do these people.
Without the help of Wellspring, I don't think I'd be here. I had thoughts of suicide when I first came to Wellspring. And I was in a very dark place. I was in a relationship and things weren't going really well. And I recall one day that I was on my way to work and I was taking the bus and it was raining. And I missed the bus and the bus like rolled right past me. And I just, on the corner, just start screaming and yelling and crying. And I just had like this really, like this moment of like, what's going on with me? It was like a breakdown. I was diagnosed with bipolar 2 and clinical depression. And I start seeing the therapist and start seeing the psychiatrist, and I really just start, my life started changing. One of the things that my therapist suggested to me that I find an outlet. I went to Illinois State University and I majored in theater. And I was always really big into theater and arts and things like that. She suggested to me that I go back and I start, you know, doing some things in theater to really get my mind off of what I was going through, to really give me an outlet. And so now I produce plays throughout the St. Louis area and I do acting lessons with students. But it was through the help of Wellspring that I really got to that point. And it's because of Wellspring that I was able to get the courage and the strength to go back into the workforce, go back into the community, go back to reconnecting to something that I once loved.
Emotionally, it was extremely degrading to be going through other people's trash to try to find something to eat. I felt like dirt. I felt like I was the trash that was in the dumpster. My name is Sharon Diaz, and I was homeless for 9 months before my bipolar disorder became out of control. I was a soccer mom, was happily married, I was employed, and I had a year's savings in the bank. That changed in the blink of an eye. It was a nightmare.
When Sharon moved into Theodore, she was suicidal. She pushed me away at first. She was very resistant.
At that time, Michelle was my life skills teacher, and she taught me a lot about myself. She taught me to believe in myself again. Sometimes she had to kick my butt to get me there.
I started seeing a smile on her face once a week. That was, you know, enough for me that I felt like I was getting to her.
My growth during that time was phenomenal. I was able to set goals for myself and become the person that I had always dreamed of being. I went from homeless and weighing 400 pounds to, you know, being able to work again and give back. I decided that I wanted to go back to work and started out working as a monitor in the group homes at Wellspring and worked through, became a life skills teacher, and now I'm a peer coach.
I mean, how exciting is that? To be able to work side by side with someone who was at their worst or at their rock bottom, and she was able to grow into the clinician that she is. I think that's amazing.
You know, Wellspring was, you know, my last shot at survival, and they did not let me down. I wouldn't be here without them.
Because of Wellspring, my future is bright. I'm excited. I'm excited about what the future holds for me.
I don't feel I'm out there alone. And I'll just never forget that.
Thank you to Wellspring. They saved my life.